Namaste. Today we are dealing with the main topic, art of positive parenting. In that, the subtopic is be in your statement. As a parent, many parents are complaining about their kids that they are very violent in nature. For getting something, they are showing many kind of temper tantrums. Anyway, they will get it. Many parents are complaining these kind of statements right now. I used to say to that parents that the temper tantrums of the kids, 50% of temper tantrums are related to the attitude of the parent. 50% of temper tantrum is related to the food that they take. First, I will come to the food aspect. This temper tantrums, as well as the craving nature of the kid, or this kind of restlessness or hyperactivity of the kid, is related to the rajoguna of the food. In the sense, whenever the food is having more of rajoguna in nature, our body and mind also will show that same kind of rajoguna, restlessness, hyperactivity, that tantrums, everything they will show. So we have to reduce our rajoguna yukta ahara, rajoguna yukta food, and give more of sattvic kind of food. In the sense, if you give more of spicy kind of fried items, and which is sour in nature, all these kind of food, and even junk foods, as well as the food which is having old food which is prepared previous day, all this kind of food is having more of rajoguna in nature. So reduce the intake of rajoguna yukta food and increase the intake of sattvic kind of food. That is the first thing that you have to do. Second thing, right now we are following a kind of routine that if kid ask for any kind of item which they like, the first statement that we say is will not give. Automatically we will say will not give that. The kids will go to the next level. In the topic stages of scolding, I said there is a rule for scolding also. There are 5 stages of scolding. The same way the kids are also having different layers to get an item. So first of all, the kid will ask for any kind of food or any toy or anything that they like. We say will not give. They will go to the next level of asking. Then also we will say will not give. Then they are going to the next level of crying and showing the tantrums, and they will just roll in the floor and all. So if they show these kind of mischief things, what as a parent, what we will do? We'll just say don't do, don't do, I will give. So there is a script in our mind. In psychology they used to say it as a script. The script has gone to the kid's mind that if I show tantrum, I will get. So we have to cut that kind of attitude of the kid. For that, what should be done? The training should be given to the parent. If we say anything that I will not give, means you should stay in that statement itself. You should not give any, at any cost, you should not give that item to the kid. Rather, you can just deviate the mind or give something else, or you can say you just keep quiet, then I will give. So that we are making a clause for getting that item. So like that, you can just turn your attitude towards the kid. Deviate the mind. That will be better idea for that. So if you say some statement, be in that statement. In the opposite side, the other side is also there. For getting, for even taking food or doing something, we used to offer something to the kid. We used to offer, if you take this, I will give you an ice cream tomorrow. Usually, parents will forget that. Kids also will forget. I used to say that if you offer something at any cost, if the kids are not asking also, you should give that item. If kids is not asking also, you should give that. This will keep, the kids will have in their mind that if my parent say no, I will not get it at any cost. If my parents say yes, even if I forget also, I will get it. So these are the two attitudes that a parent should have in the art of positive parenting, so that 90% of the hyperactivity and this tantrums will reduce for our kids. First thing, food. Second thing, our attitude. So just try it. It's quite difficult, but if you follow and make it as a routine, it's easy for us. If something your kid asks, you can say no or yes. Be in that statement. Do it. At any cost, you should give that. Okay. So for that, even not only father and mother, even the other members also in the family also should take care of this concept. If a kid is asking towards the mother, mother will say no. If they go to the grandparents, they will say, don't make him cry, I will give. This is also bad. So the whole family should be in a rapport to create a good generation in our society. Namaste.